Aquablation is another treatment modality to use for an enlarging prostate. Others refer to as BPH, benign prostatic hypertrophy or hyperplasia. So the natural enlargement of the prostate. And as the prostate enlarges throughout a man's life, they begin to see some dynamic changes in how they void in regards to frequency, urgency, force of stream, getting up at night to go to the bathroom. These are some of the early signs and symptoms that men experience with BPH. The Aquablation procedure is a robotic enhanced water jet therapy for BPH. So it's a way that we can deliver an energy source, the water jet, in a very precise manner to remove prostate tissue. And by doing that, we open up the channel from the bladder through the prostate to enhance someone's ability to void in regards to those things of frequency, urgency, their force of stream. The procedure is done in the hospital with under sedation. Each treatment is personalized, is calculated for getting the most optimal results and with minimal side effects or complications. The patients after the procedure usually stay in the hospital for one night and then are discharged home the next day with an indwelling Foley catheter. The catheter will stay in for a week and they'll be followed up back in our office to have the catheter removed, and then a voiding trial will be done. As we've evolved with these treatments over the last several years, people's health, the procedure itself, and other modalities with it, and we're able to now have some patients go home the same day. Complications initially that for any procedure, we would talk about a bleeding from a procedure, infection. People are concerned anytime you're dealing with prostate surgery is impotence, potential for erection issues, retrograde ejaculation, or incontinence, leaking of urine after the procedure. These are basically minimal with the procedure, and that's one of the benefits of having it, because that is robotically controlled and more precise where the energy is being delivered. We try to personalize this therapy, so there's going to be certain things we're going to do in the workup of a patient when they come in for BPH symptoms. We're going to be looking at the severity of their symptoms, previous treatments if they've had them, medications have they tried, dietary changes, things we call like behavioral modifications. You know, those are things where we would look at. And then depending on the results, that is the degree of obstruction, the exact size of their prostate, that helps us then in the treatment algorithm and decide if Aquablation is best for them. Having an enlarged prostate per se, it does not require having a procedure. It's how it affects their quality of life. And that's sort of driving force to start thinking of a therapy. If the other things minimally have not worked in the past, I think we have one of the largest experiences here in New England, if not in the East Coast now. So I think experience in this procedure and our volume and our outcomes would sort of definitely be one of the major things to at least consider coming here and being evaluated and see if you're a candidate for that.